From Joburg, the teams must now make their way to the Free State for a date with destiny. All right, gentlemen, our teams are on their way to Kestell. What do we have in store for them?
So our teams think they've got a nice sedate drive on the way down here. We've got something special up our sleeve for them.
Tell me, what's up, Ryan?
Susie, this year we expect our master mechanics to think on their feet. So Richard and I have devised a little curveball for them, and they'll get that surprise a little bit later today.
Ooh, look at you guys acting all mysterious. I also want to know what's going on. Tell me. Now that the teams have obtained their parts, they need to get to Kestell. We've provided them with a bucky for the journey. In it are the parts they've sourced from the warehouse, all the tools needed to complete the repairs, and a mystery box. For now, they have no idea what's inside it, but its use will soon become apparent. We've also told them to keep their phones on because we're going to check in on them during the drive.
The day started very early, didn't get much sleep in. Yeah, we almost forgot one contestant. We overslept a little bit.
Joke.
It is joke.
He just decided, listen here, I'm gonna drive.
Yeah, yeah, I just wanna get safely to the customer. That's my only concern.
I get extremely nervous. I don't want to say something inappropriate on TV.
Where he lives, there's not much traffic. When there's two cars in front of him, that's too much traffic.
I come from a small town in the Northern Cape, Boutown. I grew up on a farm there. I started to work on the tractors on the farm, and I actually realized that my passion is working on tractors. So then I decided to apply for the apprentice job and started my apprenticeship straight after school, 2012. Qualified at 2015 and started working in Hoopstad in 2016. I think the best part of my day is when I get home and I see my wife and I see my little doggies, my little children. It's important to balance your life and your work.
All that I know is he loves his wife very much.
I grew up in Tilbach, born and raised there. My last day of matric, I came to Johannesburg, and now I'm still here as a tractor mechanic. When I was in high school on school vacations, I worked on the neighbor's farm. Since then, I now want to be a tractor mechanic. I like to work with spanners and get my hands dirty. I've met my wife in 2013 and married for almost 2 years now. She's sometimes a little bit strict, but yeah, I think we understand each other really good. When I found out she's pregnant, really excited to be a dad, I think.
Now, you know, the appy, Caleb, he never uses the curse words. And I told him when I was an appy, I never used the curse. But when you qualify, the first thing you curse at is your helping hand. Because he's either breaking your tools or he's breaking a bolt off. I was also like that.
How many times did Munir have to shoot the video?
Three times.
Yes.
Okay. And well, I deleted the first tip.
Okay.
I can fix any Massey Ferguson tractor with my electronic diagnostic tool. Step one is to plug the plug into the right place. There you go.
The judges always build up surprises along the road. So I do think there's a surprise along the way. Can't go easy, it's a competition.
Hey everyone, I hope you're enjoying your drive down to Kestell. But guess what? I'm phoning with a curveball.
The moment the message came through, my heart was pounding.
Now as technicians, you are constantly receiving calls from customers who have issues with their tractors and need them repaired urgently. And that's exactly the scenario you're going to be dealing with today. Now I'm going to send you the VIN number of the tractor that's in need of repair. What you need to do is use the MF Connect app to find out where this tractor is located. Just like yesterday, the app will generate a fault code. You will need to remotely diagnose what the problem is with the tractor and then make your way to that tractor. That's right, we're taking a detour. Now, I know what you're thinking. What parts am I gonna need to fix this tractor? Well, it might have something to do with that mystery box in the back of the bucky. This is not a race, so please drive the speed limit. We'll see you when you get here, and Kestell is just gonna have to wait. The faulty tractor is located at our old friend Rooi's farm in the town of Rates, about 20 kilometers from Kestell. Gentlemen, this must be the legendary Rooi. Super nice to meet you, Rooi. Thank you so much for having us on your farm. Now, you've got an MF8727S series tractor here behind us. Do you know what the problem is? Okay, well, he obviously doesn't know what's wrong with the tractor. Richard, tell me, what is the problem and what do you think is going through the minds of the technicians right now?
I think the teams will be a little bit concerned, but once they gain the composure, The problem's not that difficult to find.
Well, the repair work itself is not very difficult, but it's not as easy as it seems. And this being reality TV, we have a few more curveballs in store for them.
The teams are getting mystery boxes, detours, curveballs. I'm excited to see how they're going to do under pressure today.
I'm going to go to my Massey Connect because my machine is at a farm and they're complaining about certain errors on our machine and we don't know what those errors are, so luckily we have Massey Connect.
We've got a new fault now. Transmission coil high pressure sensor 2 is faulty.
The air tortoise, that position sensor, is faulty.
I immediately thought that there must be a common cause of all the error codes.
One fault code could have many different meanings, so we can't just go and change the parts, but we're definitely going to make sure that we do a thorough inspection and a thorough check.
If I see those errors and these parts, you have to fix it. We haven't got an excuse.
We stopped at the garage and then we opened immediately the mystery box.
It's my Christmas in July.
So many parts. I don't know where they want to fit all those parts. Shame poor tractor. That guy must have been beating that tractor up so bad.
This is the blower phone for the aircon controller, for the aircon system.
A lot of fuses.
This thing.
This also could be the problem.
It'll also be the problem for the 5-volt system.
I think they just want to confuse us.
Special brain sunscreen.
Nice cap, I have to say it's comfortable.
We got something. We're through our knowledge objects investigating. We like police officers.
Do you think we should tell them our diagnosis? Is it safe? Don't you think it's safe? Ne?
Nothing is safe.
One part is faulty, and that will give you all the error codes on the tractor that's related to the MF Connect app.
Okay, the knowledge object is you can search for error codes. Maybe other technicians, they loaded the problem on Tech Connect, what's a similar, and then you can work from there. So it helps you a lot.
08.1.22.
Also there?
All the error codes. Boom!
Got it. What's the description? What did they do to fix the fault?
Solution. Overload on rear linkage right-hand draft sensor. There's not a draft sensor in the box. Moral of the story, they must give us a draft sensor first.
Yeah. I always tell my wife there's two kinds of days you get as a technician. The first day you go and you replace a small thing and you go directly to the fault and it's sorted. Then you feel like, wow. And then the other day you get a fault like this. If we didn't take this up,
we were going to be like afkop hoene or so.
Yeah, running around like.
The part that they didn't give us is the main part actually. That's the draft sensor. So I think there's a snake in the grass.
You don't actually know what to expect because you know how error codes work. You think it's this mistake and then you find out it's something completely different.
Hello Team Black!
Good day, ma'am. How are you?
Yesterday we were the underdogs.
Today we're gonna be the winners.
Top dogs.
Hello.
Welcome to Rates.
Thanks.
Thank you.
The weather is lovely.
Yesterday we've got credit on teamwork, but today we're going to do everything together at the same time.
Now, as you can see, the legendary Rooi is your impatient farmer today, and his tractor is in dire need of repair.
Yeah, the legs is very, you can see him from far, so.
Tell me, have you guys diagnosed the faults?
We actually found the fault to be on the draft sensor, but when we looked in the mystery box, it was not present.
And that was a bit of a surprise, was it?
That was a curveball, yes.
Here is your draft pin.
There we go. Well done finding that.
Okay. 100, yes. Okay.
Is that the right part, yes. Francois?
Draft pin sensor is a steel pin with electrical components, which helps the tractor to realize the amount of drag that is being put on the lift. So if the implement is pulling too hard or if there is too much drag on the implement, the draft pin sensor basically tells the tractor that now the lift is working too hard. So you've got to raise the implement a bit to prevent breakage of the implement and also to prevent breakage on your lift itself.
You've got 25 minutes to repair a Rooi's tractor. Are you ready?
Yes, we are.
Your 25 minutes starts now.
I think you're getting the tractor.
Let's go.
Thanks.
Go.
Baron, die draafpin al binne.
Kom vir my.
So you guys have been very mysterious today, not putting that draft pin in the mystery box. Very sneaky. How should the teams go about this challenge, Richard?
They should now be connecting the EDT tool and seeing whether it's a left or right-hand side draft pin.
The EDT is an electronic diagnostic tool.
Rather go with an EDT without tools than you go with tools without an EDT.
Now, the trouble that they've got is the error we've actually put in does throw a bit of another curveball in there. So to truly test, they're going to have to test each of the draft pins with a multimeter to check that it's got the right resistance. Then they will know whether it's left or right they need to change.
And this is what we meant by throwing them multiple curveballs, because if the teams didn't do the diagnosis properly from the get-go, they would experience a lot of frustration and time delays at this challenge.
Were you really putting them under pressure today?
They don't call it master mechanic for nothing.
No.
How's it going over here?
I think I must just check it in the front. Just going to confirm the draft pin.
Okay, Ryan, I see you had a little chat there with Team Red. I like that they turned their vehicle around, making their tools much more accessible, which is a clever strategy for me. They don't want to waste time on running.
Done with unhooking the implement.
You're unhooking it without any engine power. So you're saving some time, are you?
Yes.
They said they're going to try and do it without engine power. So if you see, Francois was actually turning the linkage pins and manually disconnecting the hitch. He believes it's a time-saving strategy.
If option B doesn't work, move over to C.
How many plans is it? Does it end at Z? Or
actually ends at ZZ.
And tell me, what was Caleb doing inside of the cab?
Caleb was basically doing just a confirmation on what they were finding on the telemetry data.
We just want to confirm on which side the prop, which side the draft sensor is damaged. The approach that we used to tackle the challenge was that I would go and make sure of what the fault was inside of the tractor, not just changing parts, because there are two draft pin sensors, so you can end up changing the wrong one and the fault would still be there.
All right, you can stop, Android.
Team Claire, you've got 15 minutes left. Lewis, it's 15 minutes to win. Where am I?
Yes.
Richard? Talk to me about the grating.
They've gone to the back of the tractor with the multimeter to check the resistance between left and right-hand side draft pin to make sure that they get left or right-hand change.
You're familiar with your own multimeter, so we had a little struggle to get the right settings.
I don't understand what you're doing. Can
you say it again? Yeah, it's
almost right here. Let's try it. This side can react
better than that. Almost panicking when that multimeter started messing around for us.
Plak net daai kant in, plak net daai kant in.
I could hear he was almost saying like heavy Afrikaans with it.
We'll get there, sir, we'll get there.
And then when I felt that pokey on the back and it was red, it was busy, just leave alone, fix the tractor.
Would I say 3 is out?
Yeah.
Overload on the rear linkage is number 51. Are you listening to me? Why I say no?
When we go out there, we plan on doing everything together, just listening to each other.
Jock!
Yeah?
It's number 51. Our error code is number 51, meaning there's an overload on our
right-hand side.
Left-hand side, meaning we have to change the right-hand side. Ooh.
What have you found?
Right-hand drive sensor is 40. We just want to make sure on the EDT, the error code, and make double sure.
Just double check.
Richard, you've checked in with Team Black. How's it going there?
Yeah, they're doing well. I think they're going to crack it with time. They've already done the testing with the multimeter. They've decided it's right. They're doing a quick double check with EDT just to be 200% sure, because they really want to be confident, this team.
Just lower a little bit. Okay, pick it up.
I can see my partner's been working on 8700 because he knew exactly how to operate the lift, exactly how to operate the gears.
All right, go up. Just checking at the bottom.
When we got the loaded load sensing pin out, I've got a little harness he used to test between the pins. So yeah, I just went in, grabbed the harness, came out.
Have you killed the tractor?
I was thinking like, I forgot a harness. Quickly grab it, nobody's looking.
Done.
Got him, done.
So yeah, I think they've been extremely fast. I'm a little bit surprised that we went that fast, but yeah, I'm happy.
How are you guys feeling? Stian, how feel you?
We didn't quite exhausted.
Yeah?
But we've done it, so Rooi can take his tractor.
Please, sir. You can have your old part.
Team Grey, well done. You just completed your second Massey Ferguson Master Mechanic Season 2 Challenge. Now it's time for the judges' assessment. Richard.
I'm happy with the work. Only one fault I can pick you up on. You didn't cable tie the harness back up.
We had a lot of time left, but I completely forgot to cable tie the harness. So yeah, that was a mistake from my side.
So as the tractor's working, if the harness gets caught on something, it may pull out the plug or cause more damage. Because of that, Grey Team, I'm going to score you 9 points out of 10.
Ryan, what do you have to say to Team Grey?
A much better start than yesterday. What are you guys doing differently?
Teamwork.
Teamwork. We definitely focused on teamwork.
Talk to each other the whole time.
You guys were definitely very, very fast. What I am going to mark you down on, though, is the health and safety aspect. I saw you operating the linkage while you were still crawling in underneath. And for that, I'm going to give you guys a 9 out of 10.
Yeah, luckily we weren't penalized too much on that.
Rooi, what did you score them? Let's see. Ah, an 8. Fantastic. That is a total of 26 out of 30.
I think it went really well. Better than we expected.
Get along the pants, the dummy, please.
The dummy?
The
what?
To eat up the...
Well, yeah, the pants in your
hand.
We have certain names for certain tools. So he gave a certain tool a certain name. And I was like, what?
Did he the dolly gekry?
What is the dolly? If he mentioned a different name or something like something else or gave a small description, I would have most definitely got it.
I'm going to bring something else.
From my side, that was my fault. I'm not clear by saying I need this, this, and this.
Okay, red team, you have 10 minutes left. Where are you, Francois?
Yes.
10 minutes to win.
Yes.
We like it.
Good so far. The pin is in. Balls, you have the balls?
Yeah.
It's almost. Relax.
almost ready. Nearly done, meneer. Just tightening the draft sensor.
We're done.
Caleb, lower the linkage, please.
too late.
Wop, wop, wop.
Caleb!
It's okay.
No, it's okay. It's finished.
How are you feeling? Come on out, Caleb.
Come on. I messed it up at the end.
What did you do there at the end?
I didn't lock the implement.
And what does that mean?
When the implement goes into the ground, it will off-hook automatically.
Oh, that's a big no-no, yes. Man. Team Red, when you started this day, you thought that all that was in store for you was a quiet drive down to Kestell. Yeah, and then, bam, you found yourselves here on Rooi's farm repairing his Rooi tractor in a town called Reitz, ne? Let's get serious because it is now time for your assessment.
You've diagnosed well using Massey Ferguson Connect. You've double-checked on EDT, and you've also used the multimeter to check between left and right-hand side with the resistance. So well done with that.
Caleb did a very good job handling the apps. He was on the ball today.
What I've also been impressed with is the tidiness of how you've worked. The tools have been restacked back on the implement, all nice and neatly. Just one thing, though. You left an extension lead in the farmer's field. So you've now lost a tool, and you're going to upset the farmer because he's going to put that in the ground.
Thank you very much, Mr. Rooi.
Because of that, guys, I'm going to score you 9 out of 10.
Are you happy with that?
Yes, yeah, with this part.
Don't look very happy, Rajwa.
Just here at the end.
I did find a few problems from your challenge. The length of the leveling boxes. Yes. You managed to lengthen them to remove the linkage, but I never saw you shorten them again.
Back.
So the settings on the ripper is ultimately out, meaning the customer is going to start from scratch to get his plow set up all over again.
Okay.
And the second issue I find almost completely unforgivable in terms of health and safety is never put the safety locks back into place. Again.
Yeah.
Which means Rooi would be just down the field there and his plow would physically come off.
At that point when I realized that I didn't release the pins on the quick hitch, I was quite shocked.
I'm giving you a 6 out of 10.
Okay.
So Rooi, do you want to tell us how much you scored Team Red? A 7. That's 22 out of 30.
What we could have done to have obtained a much better result, I could have climbed down and helped Mr. Francois make sure that everything was done correctly, seeing that all the pressure was on Mr. Francois.
Meanwhile, Team Black are struggling.
What's your pen?
What could possibly go wrong in this challenge? It's been run out of time.
Si pen kore bag.
Yes! Yes! Basje, je ziet
niet. Wacht, tel op.
Kan ik op, ja?
Ja.
When you're outside, you feel things doesn't happen as quick as you want it to happen. And inside, you can't hear with the wind blowing.
Het is gehaak, hier die kantie.
Zak.
You start talking louder. Not screaming, but talking louder. And...
Stop, zet tel op. Terwijl je vooruit gaat. Yes, hier die ding wil je aan.
Het is gehaak.
All right,
T Black, you've got 5 minutes left.
I really hate you. You f***ing really hate me.
This is it. This is where it gets hard.
Sock.
Liam, I suck.
Sock.
It's normal that you know this thing is supposed to hook up. Why isn't it hooking up?
All right, 1 minute left, guys. You got 1 minute left to figure this out.
Come on, say hello to Slack.
Counting down was, you can hear it, but you don't actually want to hear it.
I'm not going to block you.
So, shot.
Yes.
There we go. Nice one, Team Black.
All right, time. You've got 30 seconds to spare.
Yeah, finishing time.
Now it's time for the judges' assessment.
Niku Ann, I heard you yelling orders and barking at Jock. Was that effective?
It just hyped him up more. I can't expect you to react the way I would react under such pressure.
Yeah, we didn't get frustrated with each other. No. We got frustrated with the implement that doesn't hook.
Yeah.
I think if you guys communicated better, you would have perhaps improved your times. And also what I found quite disappointing was that you guys doubted yourself in terms of fitting and refitting the attachment. You guys managed to remove it, but you didn't believe that it would go back on again. In terms of scoring, I've decided to give you guys a 7 out of 10.
Richard.
The only thing I would mark down on is the old draft pin was still left on the cable ties at the back of the tractor, and the breakout harness was also left on the back of the tractor. So Team Black, I'm going to score you a 7 out of 10.
Rooi, now I know you're not saying much, but tell me, how impressed with Team Black are you? Another 7 it seems, eh? Okay, that's 21 out of 30.
The way we're feeling of ourselves, I think we're proud.
We put these teams under a lot of pressure today. Who faltered? Who came out on top?
It was for me quite interesting to see how Team Grey pulled themselves together and really made a comeback in the second challenge.
Team Grey are really starting to pull together now. Yesterday, I think they were probably just a little bit nervous, but now they're starting to get to know each other's personality. We're starting to see a team.
We are down ourselves. I think we did good. Hopefully we'll come out on top and we'll see you tomorrow.
It was interesting to see Niku Ann and Jock not quite finding each other during the challenge.
Do I think we get along well as a team? I don't think so.
Can you literally see the smoke coming out of my ears? Like, literally.
Team Red, apart from those few safety niggles and the setting issues, I actually think they did very, very well.
Finishing up today, I feel a little bit less confident compared to yesterday.
If we had worked together properly as we did yesterday, we would have definitely had a better finish, but we're definitely going to pick up the pace and pick up with our strategy again to push for tomorrow.
The teams are really under a lot of pressure.
If you're going to be Master Mechanic of 2022 and the trip to France, you're really going to have to step up your game.
Tomorrow is a brand new day. We're finally going to see them fix those MF7700 S-Series tractors. They better pull up their socks, ne?
We'll find out tomorrow.
As the teams contemplate tomorrow's challenge, the sun sets with Rooi at last being able to enjoy the fruits of their labor.
Next time on Massey Ferguson, Master Mechanic.
Come on in, everybody.
Wow.
It was a big surprise for us.
You made it to Kestell. Pretty impressive, man.
Pretty awesome.
Are you ready?
It was quite nerve-wracking. I saw two boxes, EDTs, heavy-duty sets.
I had my heart racing.
Go, Niku Ann, figure it out!
Now it's make or break.
If you like what you see, like and subscribe.